What's going on, everybody? Figured this update's gonna be pretty awesome. Just because it's been a really great week, and considering we're 3 months in, I definitely needed it. I was looking over my kind of schedule I was looking to keep this year. I had the first 4 months planned out. And the problem with that is I lost those first 2 weeks at the beginning of this year, dealing with my dad being in the hospital and everything like that. So it's kind of offset everything 2 weeks at least. I was just looking it over last night though, and I think I'm right about on track, but just 2 weeks behind. And now with the Kickstarter being funded, I think it's allowing me to catch up just a little bit more, especially now that I'm actually actively working on issue 6 now, because 5 is basically done. But I'll get to all that in a second. This week, there's been a lot of just 2016 has been a real, excuse my language, but a bitch of a year so far. I know I'm pretty upbeat in most of these videos and whatnot, but it doesn't mean that shit hasn't been going awry. I still try to keep my great attitude every chance and turn I can. But yeah, shit has been going wrong for me too. But I don't linger on it, because I figure my energy and effort is much more better utilized being positive and trying to pick people up and whatnot. So I finally got a week worth of wins this whole week. A lot of it started with working on issue 6. I got the roughs done for the first 6 pages. I was showing off the big size Tokyo Ghost issues 1 and 2, and that's been just a great tool, just because I can see what a very in the spotlight artist right now, his inks and what size he's kind of using to in comparison to the Bristol board I'm using. Also, I'm kind of going on my own path on issue 6. What I mean by that is, for the Bristol boards I use, it has the lines for the page and whatnot, has all the regular sizes and whatnot. What I'm doing with this issue is I'm flipping those pages over and just using the backside. So there's no lines, there's no guides. I think that's adding to the whole completeness of issue 6. Issue 6 is going to be a different beast, and I wanted to make it look like it. I want to find a good medium area where everything works well, but you can see what I'm focusing on, and having straight lines for everything is not necessary, because I kind of want to show this world where they've found a way for everything to work properly. But that's starting to become too comfortable, and it just needs a little rougher on the edges. So I think this looser lines design of issue 6 is adding to that aesthetic, only because I feel like that's what issue 6 is going to dictate. Now once I get the inks done for these first 6 pages, I will definitely revisit this, but they're definitely going to be loose for the preview pages that are going into issue 5. And with that being said, I have completed 3 pages of those 6 pages. I've gotten the pencils done. I'm still going to do a second stage of pencils where I add in shadows, make sure I get details in there that I want to ink. Because I'm going to use my Micron sparingly. And when I say sparingly, I'm mostly just going to be inking it by hand with a brush and ink. With that being said, I'm very excited to get to inking. I'm going to use microns for the word bubbles, narration boxes, whatnot, because those need to be very fine lined. And they've gotten so much better in issue 6. Like, I got the first page of pencils done, and I think I got a page and a half fit onto that first page, which made me redesign a few of the pages, but they were all loose stages right now. So it helped me get more of the story in there, and leave this sixth page on a really nice cliffhanger, that is hopefully gonna make people want to pick up issue 6. With that being said, all the panels are tighter, the word bubbles are more compact. I know if you've seen any of these videos where I'm working on pencils or ink stages, the word bubbles were very loose. They were pretty good size. I feel with this one they're very tight. If they're there, they're very necessary. If not to explain what's happening, but to give some more vital information from the characters. So I'm pretty excited about all that. I'm also working with sound effects, doing a couple new things, whatnot. But for these first three pages, it looks awesome. Also, the thumbnail is going to be showing a picture of a van. I hope so, if I figure that out. But that is in reference to using that picture as a reference for a splash page of these first three pages. It turned out awesome. It helped me find the lines and perspective of the design that I wanted to get, and I think that page is gonna look perfect. So I'm really excited about that. I'm really excited about these roughs so far. These first three pages of the pencils are looking dynamite, and I'm really looking forward to the next two pages and then the sixth page, getting that done, so I can get to working on tighter pencils and then inks. It's my hope to be on inks by Friday. Hopefully I will have a new update page or an update progression video next week showing me working on at least one of these pages, inking it and whatnot, and talking over it, because I love you guys and I know you love this face, but I'm really excited to show off the work that's happening for issue 6, because now that 5's done, 6 is the newest, best thing. And especially with how all the panels are laying out and everything, it's just looking awesome. And I really am excited to share that with people. This coming week is going to be slightly stressful, only for the fact that Patreon, I finished up laying out the spreads for the inks of issue 5. So next week, at this moment, I don't have anything to put on Patreon. That being said, I will have something for Patreon on Monday. I believe I'm going to be doing the spread of the secret project for issue 5, but I think it's going to be Patreon exclusive. And then everybody else will have to wait for the 5th issue to show up. So if you want to see what I've been secretly hinting at for the last couple weeks, you're definitely going to have to be a patron. With that being said, the week after that, I will be starting releasing the pencils for issue 6. And then with these 6 pages, I'll have 2 weeks worth of that. And then by that time, hopefully I'll be in the pencils for issue 6. That I can keep going with those. If not, I will have to take a week break and get caught up on pencils, but I think I should be in a good position to where I can release pencils for those. With all that being said, let's get back to this week. So I got the roughs pencils done. Artcasters was on Wednesday night. I got the second page of roughs done. I got the third page of roughs done yesterday. So that's where I'm sitting with issue 6 right now. They look awesome. And then Thursday night happened. Thursday was awesome in the most innocent of ways. I didn't feel like Thursday was going to be anything special. It was St. Paddy's Day. I made it a patron exclusive, like, Happy St. Paddy's Day. I'll put a picture of it after this, since it's been a few days. They got the exclusivity out of that, so I'll share that. Basically, I'm trying to do a little exclusive patron sketch for all my patrons, just for say thanks, so they get something exclusive out of it. I'm trying to work a little bit harder on that, but this whole last 2 months have just been a blitzkrieg of trying to get 5 finished. So Thursday night was St. Paddy's Day, but it was also a jam night, which is when I go to this bar, set up, sell comics, whatnot. A big issue has been that I go to this bar and I set up and I talk to a few people, but I never make any sales. And I figure if I can make a sale at these bars, I can pretty much sell anywhere, because it's a situation where you're not expecting to do any sales, because it's not the type of environment for that. And I go into this knowing that, but it doesn't mean afterwards, when I don't have any sales, it doesn't just completely drain me of all my energy that I put forward towards that night. I really set out this week to have the best showing I possibly could. I had my drop cloth, I had my tablecloth set up. I took prints with me. Like, I had a nice setup. I will put pictures of that I took of. It's kind of in a corner, so it's kind of hard to tell, but my layout was on point. I even dug out my buttons that I have, but I don't really advertise, but since a few of them sold, I will definitely be making more buttons and getting those on the table, I suppose. I've got to come up with a good way to show them off and advertise them, so I got to check out Scott Circlin's and Gaz's, how they set up for their button layout. So if you guys are listening to this, throw up a picture so I can see that a little bit better, of your button layout, design, whatnot. So this Thursday night had everything going well. I was set up, I was feeling great. I will do a time lapse. I put a corner, I put a camera behind me up in the corner, just kind of time lapsing the night and what's going on. You can see there's a lot of downtime, but there are a few people that stop and chat up, and a few people that that know me, but I didn't know them necessarily. And then I got a couple sales. So the time lapse is over 2.5 hours, and in that time I talked to maybe 4 or 5 people, but all I needed was 3 sales to make the night more than worthwhile. If you follow me on Twitter, you know when I showed up to this bar, my big full-size van was on fumes for gas, and that's not an exaggeration. I'm pretty sure when I pulled up, it went and turned that off. So I'm pretty sure I was very empty on my gas tank. But with those sales, I had enough money to grab gas later that night. I did have emergency gas money, so it wasn't that big a deal, but it really made everything better, because now I still have that emergency gas money. But it was awesome going there, making some sales, and actually having that to put into my gas tank. Which is something maybe you don't hear that often. But I remember when I was looking at doing cons last year, before I did my first one, a lot of people talk about how you need to set yourself up for not having many sales. And it's definitely something that's hard to prepare for. But I think after you do it a couple times and after you're working on perfecting your pitch for these people, it makes it a little smoother and easier. But nights like Thursday night happen and you're just on point. And so I sold a set of comics, sold a couple prints. And then at the end of the night, also, if you're not following Robot Friday, follow him on Snapchat. He's been doing some long form video stories, whatnot. But he was at Lubbock last weekend, and I believe he was talking about how he always stays to the end because sometimes he gets sales at the end of the night, and that's where I sold two of my prints and made a better chunk of money. So thanks for that little advice, because if I would have started pulling down my table and whatnot, I might not have had those sales. So big shout out to him. Go follow him on Snapchat for sure. Check him out here on YouTube, Robot Friday. He does Sketchcast. He should be firing up his comic strip, Robot Friday, here soon. I think he was talking about doing drawing comics this weekend. So I'm looking forward to that for sure. But that Thursday night just really solidified how awesome this week was rolling towards. Another tedious thing, but necessary thing. I know I've been talking about this Kickstarter for a few weeks now. I want to give a little bit more clarification. These things definitely aren't easy by any means. Last weekend, I spent a good day's worth emailing everyone on my contact list on Facebook. I was sitting about 50% from the total and emailing everybody I know brought that closer to 75%, I think, by the end of last weekend. But it's definitely a lot of work. It definitely took probably 8 hours to message everybody on my friends list. And that's just something you have to do. These Kickstarters aren't like, oh, you set it up on Kickstarter, everybody's cruising through the comic section just to find your special project or whatever you're doing on Kickstarter. You definitely have to get the word out and tell people that you know. Because your friends definitely want to help and support you, but sometimes they don't know what's going on and they can't support you if they don't know what's going on. So keep that mentality. I think that's a better one to have than, oh, I don't want to be spamming people with this because I don't want them to be annoyed by me and hide me. I just opened up a form of communication, and a lot of them were like, I know we haven't talked in a half a year, I know we haven't talked in a year, but I am working on this project right now and I'd love you to read it and whatnot, so check that out. If you want to see kind of a email form like I kind of send out to people, message me, samuraiox@gmail.com, and I will shoot you a little note of kind of the stuff that I wrote down and emailed to people. But it's definitely a lot of work. I hit 75% this last week and did it again on Wednesday. Started emailing some people that I had missed, some people that had said they were interested in donating, then yesterday happened and it was funded. We got 100% funded. I was so stoked that it finally hit that number and like just blown away, because I think I started out the day at a grand of 1200 that I was shooting for, and with two donations I hit that, and it was like, it was just nuts. It was just wild. I'm so thankful for everybody watching this that actually donated. I really can't put it into words how much it means to me. This being one of the most ambitious projects I was looking to do, especially talking to the printer, getting the proof ready for the trade one, and then working on getting the fifth issue together, all at the same time. Just, it's been a slugfest this last month for sure. And knowing that that's funded kind of takes a weight off. I would still love to get some more donations, but considering it's funded, I'm happy with it just being funded. And looking forward to getting these books done now. There's still going to be about 2.5 weeks before the funds get released. Probably a couple weeks to get those books done. So the beginning of May, those books should be rolling in, and I should be getting sketches done and sending them out. I will probably have them separated to the point where, if they don't need to get signed or anything, and then signed and sketched, and I'll send the ones that aren't getting signed out first. So I've got to double check and see how many are actually needing to be mailed and how many don't need to be mailed. So that's one thing. Another thing is Friday. I actually didn't think, I thought there was a possibility that I wasn't going to get funded. I think Friday night I was sitting at maybe $900, and $300 doesn't seem like that much to cover. But when you're in about 5 days left to go, and some of your highest pledges have been $20-$25, that $300 seems pretty hard to scale. So I went gambling, made a little extra money so I could cover cost of at least issue 5. Made a few $100, so that was awesome. So hitting that Kickstarter means that I can do a couple extra thanks and gracious things with some extra funds to show my appreciation for everybody that helped get these books made. And on that note, the cons are right around the corner. Thursday put me in the right mood that I'm so excited for cons now. Gaz did one this week. Check out his videos. I'm sure he's gonna have one up. I'll link his latest, I will link his last one, which is a phenomenal one, because he's talking about his Kickstarter. If you haven't watched it, go watch it. You'll see kind of this real emotion, not only from getting it started, is probably the hardest thing you can do. Kind of like dipping your toe in, seeing if the water's cool. You just have to jump in full force. And Gaz did it, knocked it out of the park, and then he recorded himself with this overwhelming excitement. And it really made me remember the first time I did a Kickstarter, and it made it, and like, literally, there are goosebumps on my arms just talking about it, because it's such an awesome video. So check out his latest. Jan's back sketching up some stuff, so check out, I'll link his channel, check out some of his videos. I'll throw some videos, time lapses on the end of this, for everything that happened in this week. I'll probably cut it off right about here, seeing as this will probably be about a minute, 30 minute video or whatever. But I wanted to share a couple more things of the pictures that are going to be coming up. One is Hex 11, I believe it's called. The first volume of their comic showed up the other day. The reason I supported their Kickstarter is because it deals with magic, but more so this chick's arm kind of has like a circuit board design with all these magic rune whatnots. I haven't gotten into it, but like, that was immediately I saw that and I was like, yep, I'm definitely pledging to this Kickstarter. It looks awesome. It doesn't look, it looks like they're a one step ahead of me, so it gives me something a little bit easier to strive to hit, like that level of professionalism. And I'm still striving to hit the level of professionalism Sean Murphy does with Tokyo Ghost. Those are the two things that I'm looking forward to, and Hex 11, like, makes it seem real attainable. If you haven't checked it out yet, I will probably throw a review in next week, because I haven't gotten to read it yet this week, but I will definitely be doing one next week just to talk about it a little bit more. They're all chick creators, lady creators, sorry. That's kind of rude, and I don't want to be rude, because they definitely have made an awesome volume one, and it makes me excited about my first volume. Along with that, we're still getting snow. it came out of the movie last night, and there was snow on the ground, and it was 40 degrees, and I was livid. I couldn't understand why it was 40 degrees and still snowing. It just blew my mind. Another one quick announcement. Found another Kickstarter that seems pretty awesome. It's about zombies. Not particularly my zombie guy, but zombies, apocalypse, whatnot. But the first picture is of this guy in a hot dog suit, and I think that's his job, but it is the zombie apocalypse, but he still has bills to pay, so he still has to work and whatnot. It just seemed like an awesome premise. I will put the link down below for that. Definitely check that out. Give him some love. I think he's got 45 days to go on it, so he's not shooting for that much, probably $300 or so, but it looks like a fun comic. The art looks awesome, so definitely check that out. It'll be in the pictures at the end, so you can see what I'm talking about with that hot dog suit. Thanks again for everybody that donated to the Kickstarter. Also, this week on Patreon is going to be exclusive special pages that are going in issue 5. You should definitely want to check those out, because they're going to be a lot of fun. I think that's going to do it for now, though. Let's cut it off there. It'll probably be about a 30-minute update. Love you guys. I appreciate all of you that have even given me attention to watch these videos and updates. You guys mean the world to me. Hopefully I'll get a couple more videos put up on this channel, but for now it's probably just going to be these updates, especially for crunch time with issue 6 and getting 5 and the trade finished up, completed, and printed. But definitely, I love you guys. Thanks for all the attention, and I'll catch you next week with a new update. Hopefully, a progression showing me inking issue 6.